Hey everyone, and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you how I make an art journal page, but not just any page. I'm only going to use regular household supplies. And the reason for that is that when you look at YouTube, there are a lot of videos displaying the most wonderful art journal pages, but they're using all kinds of fancy equipment, and that might hinder you as well to try out this wonderful activity. So for today's video, household supplies only, that I'm sure every one of you has at home. So I already filmed the video, so now I can show you the end result already. I'm actually quite happy with it. This is the page. And in this video, you're going to see what supplies I used for this and how I came up with the idea. And of course, also the final results. I hope you like the video. If you do, please subscribe to this channel and hit the bell icon so that you'll be notified whenever a new video appears. And if you have any comments, leave them down below. You can also, of course, follow me on Instagram. And there you can see what art I try to make throughout the week as well. So without further ado, let's do some art journaling. So as I said, I'm using household supplies only, and for this video I used some paper, gift wrapping paper, a sponge, magazine to cut out a picture, some coffee, glue, scissors and pencil shavings. So my first step is to crumple up the paper so that it would create a nice textural background for my art journal page. And what is important to mention is the quote that I'm using for this spread, and that is, "No one can make you feel inferior without your consent." And I find that such an inspiring quote, and I wanted to make a corresponding art journal page for that. One of the important things to remember if you make such a textural background is that you use a paper that's large enough in size, so there's some excess on all the sides, because your paper will shrink quite a bit because of all the crumpling. So it's good if you take that into account. And when you glue it down, make sure that you don't fold it down too neatly, because you want that structure, you want to keep that on your page. So this is the picture that I chose for my art journal page. I think it's such a beautiful pose and I definitely wanted to use it. It's from a magazine, so I think there's plenty laying around at home that you can use for your art journaling. I always do the rough outlines with my large scissors and then the smaller outlines and more detailed work with my smaller scissors. So I am going to glue my picture down and determining its place. And if you're just like me, struggling a little bit with where to put your images, just look up easy tutorials on the rule of thirds, which will help you out tremendously in placing your objects. Now, as you can see, I am trying to paint with coffee and make the background more brown, but it's not working out in the way that I wanted it to. And that is why I'm now switching to my transparent glue, so that I can actually glue down the coffee to my page. And this was quite an experiment, because I wasn't sure whether my glue would hold it, but it definitely did. So I was very happy with that. So now I'm just using my plate of coffee and gluing everything down to the page. And and now I'm trimming away the excess paper. I usually wait all the way up until the end to do this, so that you just have that little bit of extra space to mess around with your paint, or in this case with your coffee. And then there was one more thing I wanted to try out, and that was gluing down some pencil shavings in the bottom of my picture. Because I thought that might give her some sort of idea of rising from the ashes or something like that. And I found that very fitting for this quote. So I'm now gluing down that quote, "No one can make you feel inferior without your consent." And if you like this page and want to see more of my creative attempts, please follow me on Instagram. And if you like this video, of course, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and if you want, leave down below what kind of household supplies you use in your art journal pages, and maybe I can use that for my next video. Happy journaling! Bye!